What's up, basement dwellers? Uncle Danny here. You ever wanted to watch a horror movie where 75% of the movie is rich 12-year-old girls complaining about each other and talking behind each other's backs and getting into fights? Of course you haven't. But you clicked on this review, so we're gonna suffer together. This is hashtag horror. We open to a cold winter day where these two have just finished getting it on in a car in the middle of nowhere. These two are hairy cocks. You know what? I'm not even gonna dignify that with a joke. You can make your own. As soon as the steamy session ends, she walks into the woods and he drives off.
Where are you, Harry?
He's sitting in his car on the side of the road when he's killed, and we cut to the biggest ADD intro ever created. I mean, seriously, what am I watching? You can barely make out the names of the actors in this movie. It moves so fast. Although it might be doing them all a favor, I wouldn't want my name to be noticed in this crap either. This is Sam, and yes, that is Jessica from American Pie playing the mother of Sam, who is driving her to a sleepover with her new best friend, Sophia. They have a brief conversation about how her mother disapproves of her rich new friends.
Just remember, money can't buy happiness. It's usually just more problems.
How would you know?
Sam isn't greeted at the door. She just walks in, because that's what you do when you go to a new friend's house for the first time. Did that egg just move?
Why did you invite her? We don't even know her. We don't even like her.
Yeah, and she smells weird.
It's just her breath. Maybe she's allergic to dairy. We'll just give her some.
And of course, like all preteen girls, her friends are talking behind her back as she's walking in.
I want you to pay attention.
We cut to Dr. White talking to his daughter Kat about her behavior problems.
Bullying each other, whatever it is, I want you to stop doing that. That's gonna stop. Taking your meds? Yeah?
Dr. White asks his daughter Kat if she's been taking her medication. And while talking, he refills her prescription online while gathering apples. We cut to Harry's wife, Alex, where it takes over 5 minutes of pointless dialogue to establish that she is an egotistical snob. I mean, free spirit.
Nothing's finished around here, and the decorator promised to be done last week.
That is so frustrating.
Really winds me up. When people promise to deliver and then fail.
This should be the tagline of the movie. People promise to deliver and fail. Hashtag horror.
Thanks for the ride.
Kat gets dropped off by her father and she starts taking pictures of trees.
Tell you anything about the rumors? The old legend of this place?
No. Why, was it a brothel or something?
No.
We learn that this house was home to an artist named Jameson who went crazy and supposedly killed himself.
Ray Jameson went crazy here. There was this legendary party where...
This must be Jameson's rendition of Homestar Runner.
Yo, can you believe it?
Hey, you want to know what the whole backstory of Jameson will have to do with this movie? Almost nothing. They bring up Jameson a few more times in the scenes shortly following this one here, and then he is never mentioned again. It doesn't matter, so honestly, purge this whole backstory here from your memory. After this backstory, we watch the girls put on clothes and take pictures and get likes online. Get used to this. This makes up a lot of the movie.
It's better to make an entrance. Your mom and like a billion other people.
Kat, where'd you go after lunch? You weren't in school. Did you
cut? Alex has to leave for a while and leaves the girls with a bunch of jewelry to play with.
What are you saying about me, bitches?
Kat decides to maybe take this movie in an edgier direction than taking pictures of themselves and starts playing with a gun prop.
Stop it, Kat. Kat, put it down.
Kat starts bullying Georgie for being fat.
You're so much jiggly fat. How can you be this fat at only 12? I mean, where is his head? I'd cry too if I were you. No, actually, I would just kill my
cat. That's too far. Cut it out.
Seriously, why do these girls hang out with Kat? I mean, I've never been a preteen girl, but I know an asshole when I see one.
Are you kidding me? Kat, enough. Get out.
What are you talking about?
That's it. I had it. You have to go. I call you a car.
So Kat gets kicked out of the house by her friends, and she goes through the woods sobbing, not knowing what she did wrong. Maybe calling your friend fat and telling her to kill herself, which should have been your first clue. She makes a sobbing call to her dad to come pick her up, but her dad doesn't answer.
You never ever pick up. It's not fair.
I'm going to stitch her mouth shut and cut off her fingers so she can't do this to anyone else.
Back at the house, the girls spend, 5 minutes trying to comfort Georgie. Seriously, it goes on for about 5 minutes and leaves you with this. The girls agree to give up their phones and put them in the safe so maybe they can actually hang out with each other.
Can't you just stop looking at that? Maybe turn it off for a while? Put it down? Can't you do that? That's impossible. No one can do that.
Yeah, because we didn't all do that all the time prior to 2007. Transitions. The girls decide to have a drink. They're so grown up.
Party time.
Calm yourself, Georgie.
Hey.
Straight buck off.
Shimmy, 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 back.
And I guess Sam is a bit of a lightweight.
Wait, wait, guys, I speak bird.
And they're playing with the bird.
Okay. I'm gonna marry the mommy.
love you. I want to marry you. Oh, 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 oh.
I would say we could look it up, but we don't have our friends to look it up on.
After that point, Lucine, the girls go into what looks like a tent filled with scrambled porn and talk about when they got their periods.
In the courts, and suddenly there was all of this blood in my white skirt. And when I went to reach down to fix it, it got all over my hand.
Again, I've never been a preteen girl, but ladies, is this what you did? If so, you're gross.
But when I got home, my mom got really mad. And she told me that I got my period too early and that I need to stop eating chicken.
After their talk about their first periods, they complain about how their parents don't really know them.
But I don't eat chicken. I'm vegan. How does she not know that?
Yeah, that's a good question. Don't most vegans remind us that they're vegan at least 50 times a day?
She's trying to help. But all she does is tell me everything I'm doing wrong.
Look at those phones go. I think they're going crazy from the glitch. And after all of that scrambled porn tent chatter, they decide to go talk some more in the swimming pool.
All my friends turned on me. It was just really bad.
Sam won't go in the swimming pool because she's dreaming about blood. Actually, it's her fear of water and it's supposed to be symbolic. Want to know the backstory to that? Too bad! Because now it's time to put on masks and dance! Oh my God. You know what? Maybe it is fun. Maybe I'll try it too. Oh, thank God.
Who is that?
Who cares? It interrupted this crap.
Where's Kat?
Dr. White is looking for Kat. He rips into the girls for being spoiled bullies. This goes on for a long time, and it gets weird.
Right? It's easier that way, right? It's fucking easier that way! Do you give a shit about anyone? Do you? Do you care about anyone?
Riley swears you're my home.
The only way to scare your selfish, spoiled, and corrupt minds is to scare the shit out of little
so he threatens
head.
Them with a knife, and he's chasing
here.
Them around, and they're
Get
kind of
here.
Running.
Now it's just us, right? Why don't we just talk about this, okay? Why don't we just talk about this calmly?
You put that knife down and leave this instant! I'm gonna call the police. This is crazy. You can't treat us this way. And if you think my mother isn't going to have my back, you're wrong. You messed her tits up and she's pissed.
Yeah, messed up her tits and now she's pissed. Chasing her daughter around with a knife isn't a, no. He messed up her tits. Priorities. Sam takes off running and finds Harry's car on the road with blood everywhere. She then quickly runs back to report to the girls, but the girls don't believe her.
You can't leave us here without our phones! Sophia!
Again, priorities.
The kid's unsupervised like that.
Dr. White confronts Alex about Kat's disappearance, and They go back and forth, and call each other crazy, and really, that's about it with this scene. Moving on. After his encounter with Alex, Dr. White keeps looking for his daughter. I think he remembers that it's his daughter. It sounds like he's calling an animal.
Cat! Kitty, kitty, cat! Come on, I got some soup and a sandwich for you. Cat, honey, over here!
Yeah, you do remember your daughter's a cat only in name, right?
I have fucking friends over. Yeah, we'll have eyes over here. Yeah.
Shortly after this, Sophia finds her dead dad in the car, and she does break down.
No! No!
And we're back to them wearing masks again.
Happening if you weren't here. We would just be having fun.
Really?
Ever had real fun?
Yeah, we have real fun. We talk about our periods and wear freaky masks. It's fun. Sam is downstairs and she finds the bodies in the basement, gets attacked and escapes.
This is all tripping me out now.
I'm sorry.
What?
I just farted. Cream cheese frosting does that.
Not only are you mean, but you're truly disgusting.
Well, that added a lot.
This is Dr. White's phone.
So after diving in through Georgie's farts, they find Dr. White's phone on the floor. They open up the phone, and what they see leaves them in absolute horror. Sam meets up with Sophia in the woods, and they decide to go get their phones back.
Right now, and call the police.
And Georgie is the first one that we see die. Question. She's clearly being stabbed outside. So, how did she get into the tennis court bordered with plexiglass? I mean, okay, let's say that the killer was inside with her, inside the plexiglass, and does the stabbing. Where did the killer go? This makes absolutely no sense how this happened. The killer, and Dr. White, her father, knew about it all along. He knew about it all along because he was watching her on his phone. So if he was watching her, why didn't he know where she was? Why didn't he warn the girls instead of attacking them with a knife? In fact, why was she allowed to go anywhere if he knew she was this unstable? This movie makes no sense. This guy is a terrible father. This is ridiculous. He was freaking out earlier about who to believe when he clearly knew his own daughter was the one that was mentally unstable. Kat is confronted one last time, and she pulls the gun on herself. And we cut to this breaking news report.
Online for the world to see. The horrific images were splashed across social media. The images were followed and liked by millions of people who stood by and did nothing.
Oh, no, 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 no. Oh, no. This movie's gonna try to teach us something. This overly stupid movie is gonna try to teach us a lesson.
We're trying to prove their allegiance to a fictional online character.
Yep. About an hour and a half of absolutely pointless, contrived, preposterous dialogue, and now it feels like the last 5 minutes we're in a completely different movie. And that was hashtag horror. And the insulting icing on the cake is in these last few minutes. This movie ends trying to warn us about problems that just aren't there. It tries to be this groundbreaking, cutting-edge warning to the digital age about how we're all going to lose our grasp on reality and become so dependent on the internet we'll be desensitized to everything. Part of that is true, but not on this level. And this movie fails completely on delivering this. First, none of the girls seem like real 12-year-olds. These characters feel like what a woman going through a midlife crisis imagined 12-year-olds are like. I mean, it is insane, the stuff that they're saying. I never felt drawn into any of their conversations. Their conversations went nowhere. The dialogue and the reactions were so unrealistic that most of the time as this movie progressed, it gave me more questions than answers. Second, this is just something that would not happen online. Not on the regular web, at least. Maybe on the dark web, but let's be real. Do you think Kat could have access to something like the dark web? A site like this would be shut down so fast that Kat and her father would be in jail before you can say Marilyn Monroe egg facial. Finally, this movie is really boring up until the end, which felt forced and rushed. They spent way too much time doing nothing in this movie. We get it. They are a bunch of horrible, spoiled girls. The first hour and a half of them talking and talking and fighting and talking in multiple rooms of the house while talking and fighting and fighting and talking in all the other rooms tell us that we did not need an hour and a half to establish this. But then in the end, after making us sit through all of this pointless dialogue, it's like the director suddenly remembered, oh yeah, this is a horror movie, and gives us all the death scenes in the last 5 minutes, followed by some bullshit warning to the audience about where our society is headed. You know what this movie is? This movie is a dumber version of The Purge, and that is saying something. It's trying to open our eyes to non-existent problems by using ridiculous characters in an even more ridiculous plot. The use of the moving art in the background and all of the annoying hashtag cutscenes adds a dab of eye-rolling pretentiousness to this already terrible movie. If you were looking to be stunned by stupidity, pretentiousness, and bad dialogue, oh, this is a treat for you. I would highly recommend watching this with multiple people so you guys can go back and forth while ridiculing at how ridiculous this piece of trash really is. I was absolutely floored by how terrible this movie was. So I'm going to keep searching for more gems for you guys out there. So thanks for tuning in, and I'll see you soon.